Welcome to another Waypoint Moment. My name is Caitlin Tang, and I am a part of the amazing teen and campus ministry here in Santa Barbara. An author once said, "Some people awaken spiritually without ever coming into contact with any meditation technique or any spiritual teaching. They may awaken simply because they cannot stand the suffering anymore." In times of suffering, people look for something bigger than themselves. In times of suffering, we realize that we are just chaff that can be easily blown away in the wind. In times of suffering, we recognize that we need to be steadfast to something bigger than ourselves. Every person in the world has been affected by this pandemic in some way or another. And that is why COVID-19 is probably the greatest opportunity we will ever get in our lifetimes to share God's word with others. I can certainly say for myself, and I'm sure most of you can agree with me, that we are looking forward to the end of this pandemic. But remember, when the pandemic ends and life goes back to normal, it is very easy to part our separate ways and go back to living life as we were used to. Meaning that if we do not take this amazing opportunity now to reach out to others, it will soon be gone. Personally, it is very easy for me to get distracted and waste my whole entire day on random useless things. And that is why it is so important to respond to calls of action in this time of need. I believe that God is using this pandemic to chase us into a better life that has always been in front of us, yet we have ignored for just too long. God wants us to live our best life possible, and He lays out all the opportunities in front of us. But oftentimes, we are blinded and lose sight, and we veer off into our various directions and completely miss a purpose of life sitting right in front of us. In Exodus, God uses Pharaoh and the Egyptians to physically chase Moses and the rest of the Israelites out of Egypt. And perhaps God is using this pandemic to chase us away from our old habits. God suffers when we are not living our best lives, and He cares about us so much that He would send a pandemic to tell us, "Stop, rest, and wait. A better life is coming. You need only to be still." God allowed for Jesus, His one and only Son, who He loved so dearly, to suffer, be crucified, and experience one of the cruelest forms of death that there is, so that eventually a greater good would come. If God allowed Jesus, His one and only Son, to suffer through so many trials and pains, the fact that we are suffering through this crisis just shows how much more God truly loves us, that He really has an amazing plan in store for us. God commands us over 100 times in the Bible to give thanks. Giving thanks is such an easy yet practical way to connect with God. One of the best things I've found in practical ways is to keep a gratitude journal. But other things like giving prayers of thanks or any other method you could think of will probably work just as well. And they all remind us of how much God has given us and how much we actually have. And it reaffirms us that God is always there for us and will continue to bless us and love us despite our situation. So remember this, to take this once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to share the good news of God with your friends, families, and strangers, and to make sure that God's name is known throughout the world. God has placed us in this situation and has us all here for a reason. Respond by action in this time of crisis, and God will bless you abundantly. Thank you so much for watching. Comment down below of what you are grateful for, and we'll hope to see you soon. Have an amazing day.